Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Please be seated. For many children, this is an exciting night, full of anticipation, excitement, wondering if Santa might come, and will they get that special gift that they had been hoping to get. As adults, we tend to lose that sense of excitement and anticipation. But tonight of all nights is a time for adults, too, to regain that sense of wonder in this night. There's one Christmas that stands out for me from my childhood. It was when I was a young teenager. And we had rather modest presents. We did have presents under the Christmas tree, but they were always quite modest. My mother had grown up very poor, and she got very excited about Christmas. In fact, I think she was more excited about Christmas than my brother and me. This particular Christmas, my father had bought for my mother a very extravagant gift. And he was so excited about it that he couldn't wait. He needed to share it, so he talked to my brother and me and told us what he had gotten for her. I was so afraid in those 2 weeks before Christmas that I might say, please pass the, and say what he was going to give her. But Christmas came, and I didn't spill the beans. So we started opening some presents, and I'm sure I liked the presents that I got. I have no idea what I had. Because I was excited for my mother to get her package. And so I'd kind of watch out of the corner of my eye to see when she came to that package. And when she got the package, she started ripping off the paper, and then she took the lid off. And inside the box was fur stole. She looked inside the box. Her eyes got really wide and her mouth flew open. And she looked at my father and looked back and looked at my father as if to say, is this real? Is this really for me? And as exciting as it was for me to see that, what I remember the most was looking at my father. Because when I looked at him, I saw utter joy on his face. That he could give an extravagant gift to the woman that he loved. A symbol of how much he loved her. And I saw the tears in his eyes. And I had tears in my eyes too. Tonight we gather together to engage our imaginations and enter into this story, this incredible story of the exquisite gift that God has given us in His Son, Jesus. Hundreds of years before the birth of Jesus, the prophets had spoken of a Messiah that was going to come. The people during Jesus' time felt like they knew what to expect. He was going to come from the house of David, the great warrior king. So he probably was going to be a powerful warrior. He would overtake and overthrow the oppressors, the Roman army. He would set things straight. That's what they expected. It's kind of like we sometimes expect God to behave in certain ways. But the circumstances and the manner of Jesus' birth was not what was expected, nor was his life. The angel Gabriel unexpectedly paid Mary a visit. She was a young girl. She was engaged. And Gabriel told her that she had found favor with God and that she was going to bear a son. and that son would be conceived by the Holy Spirit. And she heard the name that she was to call this baby. It was Jesus, which means the Lord saves. The timing didn't seem right, because toward the end of her pregnancy, she and Joseph, her fiancé, were going to have to travel 70 to 90 miles. It was a grueling trip to go from Nazareth, your hometown, to Bethlehem, because Bethlehem was the city of David. So each person had to go back to their ancestral home to be registered to pay taxes. Mary knew that her time was near. Her older cousin Elizabeth had tried to tell her what the signs would be. So she knew it was about time for the baby. While they were in Bethlehem, Joseph went from door to door, frantically knocking on the door. Do you have room? Do you have room? My wife is going to have her baby. It's time. Do you have room? And door after door was opened and then closed because their journey had taken longer. No doubt they had to stop many times for Mary. There were no rooms available because everyone had crowded into their ancestral home if they were from the lineage of David. Finally, Joseph knocked on one door, and a kind housekeeper said, I don't have a room, but what I do have, I offer to you. And it was an enclosure where he kept animals. He said, it's not much, but you're welcome to stay there. It was dirty, probably smelly, but at least it got them out of the elements. So the baby was born. This one, the Messiah, the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, Prince of Peace, was born in an enclosure with animals. And his crib would be a feeding trough. What kind of king was this to be? What kind of Messiah was this to be? When Mary said yes to the angel Gabriel, let it be according to your word, I'm sure she didn't expect something like this. Perhaps she thought, because my baby will be the Messiah, will be the King of Kings, God's own son, then perhaps he'll be in a fine place, have linen wrapped. But not this. And yet this is where our Lord was born. Tonight, we stand alongside the shepherds, these lowly shepherds, because they received the first birth announcement. And we gaze in awe at the God's gift of his one true son. And it's a gift to all people and to all creation. This night of all nights, we're invited into the amazing story, the incredible story in which God has come into our human history. God has taken on human flesh. His name is Emmanuel, God with us. God has come into our story, and we're invited to enter in fully into that story. He was breaking into our history. He was entering into the messiness of our life, and where he was born was indicative of that messiness. God in human flesh, Emmanuel, God with us. No longer is there distance between God and human beings. In Jesus, God became one with us. Jesus, God became fully human, so that we might be made one with God. When Mary said yes, she became the Christ bearer. And she also brought forth the Messiah, Jesus Christ, the Lord of Lords, the Savior of the world. She brought forth Jesus into the world. We too are to be Christ bearers. We too are to bring Christ forth into the world. And we do that by showing love and compassion to all people. We too, like Mary, are to put our trust in God. We may have expectations, but I think we're supposed to expect the unexpected. So when we open up the doors of our hearts and invite Jesus in, if we do, we will find him in many unexpected places. For one thing, Jesus will come and abide in us, and we'll abide in him. We will see him with the poor and the oppressed. We will see him in the bread and the wine. We will find him whenever two or three are gathered in his name. God delights to give his very best to those he loves. And he has given Jesus, his son, to all of us, here and far away, past, present, and future. And I think when we open up our hearts and invite Jesus in, I think maybe that angels burst out in song, and I wonder if on God's face there's the look of joy that I saw on my father that Christmas a long time ago. Glory to God in the highest, and peace and goodwill to all persons.